Okay, so hello guys. Now we're going to see conditional statements. So conditional statements are really, really important in Python or in any programming language to say. So first of all, let us understand why do we need conditional statements. So while programming, sometimes it may happen that you want to run some bit of code and you don't want to run some bit of code. I know it sounds a bit weird, but okay, I'll tell you an example. So suppose you are taking any number x as integer input, and now your teacher or anyone told you to print out positive if x is greater than 0 and to print out negative if x is less than 0. Now what will you do? Because we have some conditions now. If x is greater than 0, then we have to print something. But if x is less than 0, we have to print something else. Now what will you do? So for this we need conditional statements. So we have to specify some conditions, and if that condition is satisfied, then only some part of code will execute in this way actually. So conditional, so what we have to do if x is greater than 0. So what I said is if x is greater than 0, that's what is the syntax actually. So if x is greater than 0, that's really easy. So if x is greater than 0, then if this is the condition actually. So this part is if, after this highlighted part is the condition, and after this comes the colon. So if this condition is true, then it will go inside this loop now, or condition now. See, when I pressed enter after this thing, I got my cursor over here and not over here. This thing means indentation actually. Indentation means four spaces. This indentation is really important in Python. So if this condition is true, then I have to specify some code. So I'm having any code, any number of code. So I'm having code 1, code 2, code 3. So if this is true, then this condition will execute. And after that something I write something as print thank you. So see, what will happen here over here is, if x is greater than 0, then it will go inside this loop and it will execute all these statements. But if this condition is not true, that is if x is not less than 0 or not greater than 0, then it will not go inside this condition at all. It will directly come to this statement directly. It will not go through these three lines at all. So I'll write some, you know, real code here. So if x is greater than 0, what I have to print is positive. And after that I simply printed out thank you. So I'll just run this code now and see, I wrote suppose 5. Now what happened over here, see, it printed out positive as well as thank you. So we'll see what happened. So we entered x as 5, then if x is greater than 0, so this condition, so 5 is greater than 0, so this is true. So if this is true, then it will execute this statement inside the condition. So 5 is greater than 0, true, that's why it printed out positive. Then it came to the next line and it printed out thank you. Now this is for if x is greater than 0. So what if this condition is not satisfied? So it will not satisfy when I enter some negative number like -3. Now it printed out only thank you. Why this happened is, see, if -3 is greater than 0, so is -3 greater than 0? No, it is not true, it is false. So it will not go inside this part at all. It will directly skip to this next line and it will print out thank you. So that's how it works actually. And there is actually one more type of statement over here. Conditional statement to be really. So what happens over here, if, and there also, see, I'll tell you all, if then else if elif else and nested if. These many are the types, but we'll see in brief now. So we saw if now, after that I'll just type else. So when I typed else, see, what does this mean is, simply in English you can understand. So if x is greater than 0, then this, but if x is not greater than 0, that is else. What we else, the meaning of else is, if this condition is not satisfied, then it will go to else. Now else, what we have to print out. So this statement means x is greater than 0, no, it is not greater than 0, then else what we'll do is, we'll print out it is negative, because if it is not positive, then obviously it is negative. So exclude 0 for this time now. So I write 45 suppose, this is positive, so I simply printed out positive. And I enter some negative number, it will print out negative. So when I enter positive number, it will say, yeah, this condition is satisfied, it will print out positive. Then it will not go to else, because this condition is satisfied, so it will directly come to the next line. So I'll type some next line over here again. So what I'll do is, I'll print out thank you. Yeah, and when I run this code, see, I enter positive number, it printed out positive. Because this condition is satisfied, then it will not check this condition at all, it will directly come here. It will print out thank you directly. But if I enter some negative number, it printed out negative and thank you. So what happened over here is, x is greater than 0, no, it is not greater than 0, else what we will do? So else we will print out negative. That's what we did. Then we came to the next line and we printed out thank you. That's how it worked actually. Then there is one more thing. If, elif and else. So I'll just change something. Yeah, age. I wrote age because it is an easy example to understand. So now the problem is we have to say whether a person is able to vote or no. If he's from 1 to 18, he can vote. If he's from 18 to 21, he cannot vote actually. From 1 to 18, sorry. Then after 18 to 21, he can vote. After 21, suppose we want to print out he's adult. So we have these three cases now. If age is from 1 to 18, we have to print out he cannot vote. But he is from 18 to 21, we have to print out he can vote. And if age is greater than 21, we have to print out he's an adult. That's what we have to do. So for that, we will require three conditions. That is if, elif, and else. So what is the meaning of elif? Elif just stands for else if. So we'll write something. So see, if age is from 1 to 18. So I'll write it like this. So age is from 1 to 18. We can use equal to as well, like this. Less than equal to, you know it obviously. So after that, we'll just give a colon. And after that, if this is true, then what we have to do is we have to print out you cannot vote. So I'll simply print out you cannot vote. Yeah, this thing is true. Afterwards, if I have to write else if, that is elif. Else if just means elif. And else if we have to specify a condition now. The condition was from 1 to 18 he cannot vote, but from 18 to 21 he can vote. So suppose I write 18 less than equal to age and up to 21. So if this condition is true, that is if his age is from 18 to 21, then we have to print out he can vote. Yeah, so I'll just print out you can vote. And afterwards else. Now in else I didn't specify any condition. I'll tell you why. So I'll print out something first. What I have to do is I have to print out you are an adult. Yeah. So see, if age is from 1 to 18, then it will say you can vote. Sorry, you cannot vote. But if this is not true, then it will go to else if. So what if the age is from 18 to 21? So if this is true, then it will print out you can vote and it will simply skip to the next line. I'll type the next line as well. Next line outside the loop I have to type. So I'll just type on outside the loop. I'll print thank you. Yeah. So I'll run this code now. See, when age is from 1 to 18, if this is true, it will print you cannot vote. And it will simply skip to this statement directly, thank you. Because these all are obviously not satisfied at all. It will not check them actually. So see, afterwards, if this age is not from 1 to 18, this is false, then it will come to elif. That is, it will check else if age is from 18 to 21. So if this is true, then it will print out you can vote. It will print out you can vote and it will not check this condition. It will directly skip to you, thank you. And see, one more thing. If this is not true, then this will get executed directly because else. What does else mean? These two are not true. Then it will have to execute this at any condition. So in this we'll see all the three cases now. So if I enter age from 1 to 18, suppose I write 14, it is true for this thing, this first if condition. So this is true. It printed out you can vote and it skipped to the next statement and it printed out thank you. Now we'll write some age from 18 to 21. Suppose we write 20. See, it printed out you can vote. So what happened here? It checked this condition. This is not true. So it skipped to else if. So it checked if age is from 18 to 21. Yes, it is there. So it is true. So it printed out you can vote. And after that, it directly skipped to this line, next line. And now if I write something like something greater than 24. So if I write 34, it will print out you are an adult. So what happened here? This is not true. Then it will come to else if. Then again, this is not true. Then it will have to execute this statement because else means for any age that is not from 1 to 18 or from 1 to 21. So for any random age, you are an adult. So suppose I write any random age like 103. I know this is not possible, or it may be possible, I don't know. So it will print out one and you are an adult because we don't have to specify any conditions for else. You can write one more elif loop actually. Condition, sorry. So you can write one more elif that if age is less than equal to 21 and up to suppose 50, then we can write anything. Print you are adult. Here I'll write something else. I don't know what to write. I'll just write you are adult. Yeah. So what if I run this now? So we saw these three. Now if I write age from 1 to 21 to 50, I write 34. It will print out you are an adult. And whatever, same thing. So now, okay. If I write age greater than 50, so that means if I write say 54, then this condition is not true. It will come to this condition. This is not true. Then this is also not true for 54. But this will execute now because see all these three are not executed. So else. So else means it will get executed. So when I run this code and I write 54 and I run it, see you are an adult, adult. It will print out and it will just skip to the next statement. So what we saw if condition, we saw if and else condition, we saw if and elif and if elif else. Now there is one more condition known as if nested if. We'll see nested if in the next tutorial. I think this is more than enough for now. You can practice more examples for yourself, but I think this might be a bit tough to understand, but it's really easy once you practice it. So that's all for this video. Thank you.